Hello everyone, in this demo I'll be presenting how I did my project. In this project we were asked to write down all the words that were in our head at the time. For my words I wrote confusion, exhausted, excited, movement, journey, development, change, overthinking, growth, anxiety, stress, mindfulness, tranquility, claustrophobic, motivation, improvement, growth, light, creativity, and many more. To begin this project, I created a sphere and a rectangle plane along with two sub-D surfaces. I then placed a sub-D plane and manipulated it into the shape I wanted. Here you can see how to add a surface to an existing sub-D surface. Click Shift and Control on the desired surface and drag the arrow on the point. I did this multiple times to achieve the spike-like shapes. I also added a sub-D division to add more surface layers on the sub-D plane before extruding the shapes. I then duplicated the surface and deleted the edge of each individual spike to create a pointed edge. I did this by selecting the edge, holding down Shift and Control, and then pressing Delete on the keyboard. I then use the rotate button to rotate the view of the screen and click on the spikes that I missed on the first time. After that, I created a curved line using Control Point Curve, selecting the shape I wanted, then pressing Enter, and adding a pipe on top using the Pipe tool. I clicked on the curve and set a starting radius and an ending radius, then clicked Enter. I was left with this shape that looks like a tree trunk. I repeated the move. Pipe around to create the desired shape. I then pressed copy and paste and moved the second version to an angle to create more of the tree-like shapes. I also used the blend tool to blend the pipes to connect it into one shape. Then I used the tween curves to create a more organic shape. I drew two organic forms using the control point curve on the top view and then moved one slightly higher than the other. Then I typed tween curve in the command bar and clicked on both surfaces and changed the number to 8 and pressed enter. After that, I extruded the shape, making sure to only extrude from one side. Then I typed the twist tool in the command bar and followed the instructions by clicking and selecting the angle of the twist. Here I used the same tools as previously explained to create the desired effect that I needed. I used the tween curve to create the spiral looking object in the back and duplicated some of the existing tween curves, as well as used the pipe tool to create a branch coming off of the waterfall, and used the tools box and sphere. After that, I set the view to wireframe and worked on the cubes on the side. I used the box corner to corner tool and created 8 smaller cubes inside the existing ones by clicking on the surface and following the command instructions. Another way to do this is by copying and pasting the existing tools and using the 3D scale to scale down. For the spiral shape in the back, I typed spiral and created a spiral, making sure the bottom radius is larger than the top radius to create a spiral that slowly grows larger as it goes backwards. I then used the pipe tool to create the surface on top.